I recently had the opportunity to open a seminar that was conducted by the Riddit Institute and had the opportunity of launching this document here, A Call for Arms. For anybody interested in the challenge that the agri-food sector faces over the next 20 years, have a look at it. It's a good report. It lines up very well with the government's economic growth agenda, where we are saying repeatedly to New Zealanders that if we want to have a first-class education system, a world-class health system, the social support that's been the history of this country, we have to deliver more economic growth. And when you consider that agriculture, primary production is the absolute backbone of this economy, this Call for Arms report is a challenge to all of us involved in the agri-food sector to lift our earnings. I was pleased in reading the report that the report acknowledges the work the government's doing. We've established the Primary Growth Partnership, and as of today, we have $590 million worth of projects underway. That is a start, with government working closely with industry, finding mechanisms by which on our farms we can increase productivity to meet this challenge of greatly growing New Zealand's export, particularly from primary production. If you accept that at the moment exports have grown from primary production at a rate of 3 or 4%, to meet the target of trebling the amount we produce over the next 25 years, you've got to see a growth rate of 7% per annum compound. That's a big challenge for our sector. In the next week, I go up to what's become known as the boot camp at Stanford University. I'll be there through part of the boot camp, and this has been something that has been put together by John Brackenridge of New Zealand Merino. He has worked closely with others and has managed to assemble 20 of the top chief executives of the companies of New Zealand involved in primary production. From that boot camp, I hope we're able to come back with some real strategic ideas of how the industry can accept the challenge of growing agricultural production in this country. Government's prepared to work with the industry. We've made that absolutely clear. The challenge now is for the industry to accept the challenge on behalf of every farmer, every horticulturalist, every orchardist in New Zealand, every fisher, to make sure that collectively we find a way to advance the economy of New Zealand so that in 25 years' time we have a world-class economy, allowing us to then, as a government, to deliver the aspirations to New Zealanders